Good afternoon, Father Roger Graham, family members, other members of the congregation. Love thy neighbor as thyself was Andrew's favorite commandment, and he thought that it could stand alone for a perfect world. This loving soul was born June 19, 1943, to Karl and Gloria Shervington, with the given name Karl Andrew Washington Shervington. He was the sweet-natured role model of a big brother to John and the youngest girl, aka Bush, sadly predeceased. Some call him Carly, but it was Andrew that became the no-name that he responded to proudly, always reiterating its meaning to be brave and courageous. This trait developed within young Shervington amongst his close friends Edward, Malik, Chuko, and Joe. He was probably the first to take the big step at age 18 by marrying his love, Grace Duane. In short order, he proudly wore the crown of fatherhood with his firstborn, Andrea, followed by Joan, then first son, Gregory. Assumed the position, he then, Andrew was the beneficiary of the love and respect of his grandfather as well as his father-in-law, who mentored him and presented opportunities that helped shape him to be the man he became. Trustworthy, smart, and well-loved by all who encountered him. Throughout his entire working life, he proved to be a fast learner, hardworking, and respectful to fellow workers at all levels. From his first job at the Mayfair Library to Central Motors Limited, then on to T. Geddes Grant Limited at TGG, where he spent much of his working years initially as traveling salesman for the Western region for the automotive division, moving up the ladder to assume the position of general manager for Tire Sales Limited, a division of TGG. He later took up the position as a consultant to his longtime friend and confidant, John Mahfood of Jamaican Teas Limited. After being widowed in the early 1980s, he single-handedly pressed on with his nurturing ways. And a decade later, a union with Janice Marsh culminated in the birth of his second son, Jonathan, in 1993. Andrew liked to get things done himself. Every weekend, you could look forward to him mowing the lawn, finding something in the house to repair, or serving one of his vehicles. And from a distance, you may or may not hear very original Jamaican bad word here and there. He would always share his upcoming projects for the following weekend with Jonathan in a manner that sounded like he was asking him for help, when really he was just eager to share his passion and more teachable moments. Andrew married Maxine Gopal in the late 90s and fathered his third and last son, Kyle. Fate would have it that shortly after, he was diagnosed with prostate cancer. Life went on, and this diagnosis did not derail his role. He moved his young family to the United States of America. And once they established a firm footing, he returned home to Jamaica, where he was most comfortable. Soon after returning home, he had the chance of meeting his lovely Karine Hansen, his partner for the remainder of his life. From the day they met in 2014, they were never apart from each other. He had a vivacious love for motorsports, which seemed to also run in his blood. and was quite involved with the startup of Dover Raceway. He was a walking encyclopedia for anything to do with cars. Andrew equally loved the outdoors, and bird hunting was his hobby for the major part of his life. He was a member of a group called Thursday, and always anticipated word on the location of the next gathering. In more recent times, when he was unable to physically link up, he would actively keep in contact via WhatsApp and phone. He always remained candid, and at many doctors' visits, the reception room was a happy place once Andrew stepped in and made light of his circumstance. One in particular was when a female stepped out of the way of his maneuvering his walker. As his vision was blurred, he thanked her with a compliment by saying, "I can't see the face, but I can see the shape." He took the helm as contractor for the renovation on Gregory's Mandeville home, and he found it particularly therapeutic and couldn't wait to venture from Kingston to Mandeville on the weekend with Kareem. We owe a debt of gratitude to her for her unfailing commitment to making him comfortable right to the end. When the angels came to take him home, he was ready. He was tired of being sick and in pain. He bravely placed his hand into the hand of his Lord and Savior and stepped pain-free and whole onto the blissful shores to dwell forever with his Lord, whom he dearly loved. We will love and miss him as long as we live, but we are comforted by the words of Christ himself when he promised and said, "In my Father's house are many mansions. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. And where I am, there you may be also. Rest in peace, eternal Andrew, till we meet again."
My brothers and sisters, please stand. Enter into Jerusalem, let us go to God's house. Come and run with the wind, with the God who reigns in peace. Let us go to God's house, we go celebrate. We go celebrate, we go celebrate. O Israel, praise the name of the Lord on high. Praise his name in song. Praise the Lord with a heavenly song, with a heavenly song, with a heavenly song. Praise the Lord. And with your spirit.
Praise be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all who must live. He comforts us
Enter into Jerusalem, make we walk down there, with the young and the old, with the little and the large, make we walk down there. Enter into Jerusalem, make we walk down there, swing to the breeze with the God who reigns in peace, make we walk down there, we go celebrate, we go celebrate, we go celebrate, O Israel. Praise the name of the Lord on high, praise His name in song. Praise the Lord with a heavenly song, with a heavenly song, with a heavenly song. Praise the Lord. Enter into Jerusalem, let us go to God's house. With your papa and your mama, with your uncle and your aunt, let us go to God's house. Enter into Jerusalem, let us go to God's house. Run and catch a breeze with the God who reigns in peace. Let us go to God's house, we go celebrate. We go celebrate, we go celebrate. Oh Israel.
The night will soon be here when no one can work.
As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world.
I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he dies, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this?
Yes, we believe that Jesus is the anointed one, the Son of God, He who is to come into the world.
Our life is hidden now with Christ in God. When Christ our life appears, then we shall appear with Him in glory.
If we have died with Christ, we believe that we are also to live with Him.
He who raised up the Lord will raise up Andrew and us along with Jesus and place us in His presence.
Both in life and death, we are the Lord's.
We know that Christ has raised from the dead.
He will never die again. Death has no power over him. We know also that our own death is the beginning of our salvation in the victory of Christ. We believe that God is faithful to His covenant, and He will give us fullness of life on the last day.
Let us pray. Almighty Father, you raised your Son, Jesus Christ, from the dead, so that we, who believe him to be the light of the world, may with him be brought to the fullness of his resurrection. Grant, we ask you, that our brother Andrew, who has left this world, might merit your forgiveness for the sins he has committed and inherit eternal life. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
You may be seated for the first reading.
There is a time for every occupation under heaven. There is a season for everything, a time for every occupation under heaven, a time for giving birth, a time for dying, a time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted, a time for killing, a time for healing, a time for knocking down, a time for building, a time for tears, a time for laughter, a time for mourning, a time for dancing, a time for throwing stones away, a time for gathering them up, a time for embracing, a time to refrain from embracing, a time for searching, a time for losing, a time for keeping, a time for throwing away, a time for tearing, a time for sowing, a time for keeping silent, a time for speaking, a time for loving, a time for hating, a time for war, a time for peace. What does a man gain for the efforts that he makes? I contemplate the task that God gives mankind to labor at. All that he does is apt for its time. But though he has permitted man to consider time in its wholeness, man cannot comprehend the work of God from beginning to end. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I now invite Dr. Anne Fenner to do the responsorial psalm.
Shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over.
My shepherd, I shall not want.
Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever, 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 forever.
We now have the second reading. Jonathan?
Reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Visible things last only for a time, but the invisible are eternal. We know that he who raised the Lord Jesus to life will raise us with Jesus in our turn and put us by his side and you with us. You see, all this is for your benefit, so that the more grace is multiplied among the people, the more thanksgiving there will be to the glory of the Lord. That is why there is no weakening on our part, and instead, though this outer man of ours may be failing into decay, the inner man is renewed day by day. Yes, the troubles which are soon over, though they weigh little, train us for the carrying of a weight of eternal glory which is out of all proportion to them. And so we have no eyes for things that are visible, but only for things that are invisible. For visible things last only for a time, and the invisible things are eternal. For we know that when the tent that we live in on earth is folded up, there is a house built on God for us, an everlasting home not made by humans in the heavens. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand. Alleluia, alleluia, I'm so glad to tell. Alleluia, alleluia, with my soul it's well. Alleluia, 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 praise ye the Lord. Alleluia, 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 praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Alleluia. Praise ye the Lord. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me will never die. Alleluia, alleluia, I'm so glad to tell. Alleluia, alleluia, with my soul it's well. Alleluia, 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 alleluia,
praise be the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord, alleluia, praise ye the Lord, alleluia, praise ye the Lord, alleluia, praise ye the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going to prepare a place for you, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You may be seated at this time. On behalf of the Saints Peter and Paul community and myself as pastor, we'd like to extend our deepest sympathies to the family and friends of Andrew. And as we come as family, friends, a community, anytime we approach a death, it should be with some sense of gratitude to God for having blessed us with the gift of our brother Andrew, and a sense of gratitude towards Andrew himself. It is the place where our grief meets gratitude, where our sorrow meets hope, and where we are reminded that love is stronger than death. The author of the book of Ecclesiastes in chapter 3 reminds us that time is a very precious thing. And some years ago, I received a card from a grieving family that had the same words. Time is a very precious thing. But today I offer you the words with something else. Time with family is a very precious thing. I have been in experiences at hospitals where at the bedside of parents, they've seen their daughter who was just born live for 6 hours. I've seen other persons burying loved ones at the age of 105. And one thing is clear, that whether we understand time to be long or short, when it comes to those whom we love, time is always short. But it is always precious as well. Because for those parents who had lost that 6-hour child, it was a lifetime of love invested in their daughter. For that family who spent 105 years through different generations enjoying the company of their great-grandmother, it was hard to experience life without her presence. But whether it is 6 hours or 105 years, it was still precious and invaluable. The scripture reminds us in the Psalms that, Lord, make us know the shortness of our lives, that we may gain wisdom of heart. For when we understand how short life is, it helps you to realize that you cannot afford to waste any time at all. And that we invest ourselves in the things that are of tremendous value, and that which we can take with us and leave for other generations. And scripture reminds us, as St. Paul says, the three things that are eternal are faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these are love. It is that love that we celebrate today. It is that love that we celebrate forever. It is because of love that we understand time to be precious. And it is because of that gift of love, no matter how short a period our experience is in relationships, it is still a lifetime of experience. I share with you a story of a gentleman who was very ill and went to his doctor and did a number of tests and was awaiting some results. he decided that he was not going to be depressed about how gravely ill he felt. And he went out for a long day and stopped watching the phone, listening out for the call with the results. He went and he enjoyed a wonderful day on the beach and returned to see 70 odd messages on his phone. And when he answered, he realized that it was his doctor trying to get him urgently. And he called him back and said, "I see that you left a number of messages. It doesn't seem like it's good news at all." And the doctor said to him, "It is very bad news. And I have even worse." And he said to the doctor, "Well, what is the bad news?" He said, "You have one day to live." And the man started to weep. And in his grief, it struck him and he collected himself and said to the doctor, "Well, what could be possibly worse than being told that you have one day to live?" And the doctor said, "Well, I've been trying to reach you since yesterday. So technically, but as this person chose to spend his time on a beach, what will we spend our lifetime doing? What will we invest ourselves in? What relationships will we sacrifice for? Will we build upon? Will we share in this lifetime, realizing that time is short? It is important to understand that our relationship with Christ, who is the resurrection, is key to understanding, believing, and realizing that death is nothing to fear. And that the more we love Christ, is just the more powerful we understand the gift and the grace of loving others. That when we are in right relationships with Christ, with our fellow brothers and sisters, and with creation, we would have truly spent our time wisely. When Jesus speaks of He being the way, He is trying to communicate to us that the way of love is the way of life. That His way is the way of love, and it is the way to eternal life in God. When we examine our own life, our own timeline, our own stories, and we ask ourselves, do we know the way? Do we know the truth? Do we know the life? Do we know Jesus? My brothers and sisters, Andrew invested himself in God and in you. And it will always seem like a short time that we have to enjoy these relationships. But if love is stronger than death and endures past death, then love doesn't really die. And if love doesn't die, it still remains. And while we may lose the physical presence of our brother, his love for you and your love for him endures. Because love cannot die, and it is stronger than death. I would even argue that love is stronger than time itself. So there's no reason to stop loving, no reason to stop receiving his love, because that endures and continues. And that is why Jesus says to us that I am preparing a place so that where I am, you may be too. You can enjoy a relationship in the kingdom of God here on earth and in the lifetime to come in heaven. And even in both experiences, love, faith, and hope endure forever. To our brother Andrew, we say, thank you and walk good. I invite you to stand at this time as we offer our universal prayer on behalf of our brother Andrew and ourselves. Let us pray with faith and confidence to God, our Father, who lives and reigns forever and ever and can do all things. He raised his Son, Jesus Christ, from death. May he give peace and salvation to the living and the dead. Your response, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer. For Karl, who was baptized and was given the promise of eternal life, that he may be admitted to the company of the saints and be welcomed into the peace and joy of God's heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord. Hear our prayer. For our brother Andrew, who was nourished at the table of our Savior, welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the family and friends of Andrew, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, and may be strengthened in the faith by his grace. We pray to the Lord. For the happy repose of the soul of our brother Andrew, whose faithful and gentle lifestyle has touched so many and for which we as a faith community are most grateful. We pray to the Lord. For an end to all violence, crime, and injustice, hunger here in Jamaica and throughout the world, that God will unite all people in peace and harmony, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer
for our departed brothers and sisters, and cleanse them of their sins, and grant them the fullness of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated for our collection. There is a walk of collection to the basket at the front.
Hear, O Lord, the sound of my call. Oh, hear, O Lord, and have mercy. My soul is longing for the glory of you, O hear, O Lord, and answer me.
We sing.
Hear, O Lord, the sound of my call. Oh, hear, O Lord, and have mercy. My soul is longing for the glory.
That my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the offering of this sacrifice be pleasing to you, O Lord, so that the soul of your servant Andrew, finding through your mercy the pardon he sought for his sins, may exalt forever with us your saints and praise your glory for all eternity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of the blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord our God. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord our God. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna. Please kneel if you're able to.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Please stand. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Kenneth, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Andrew, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in all our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be free from all sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her the peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Oh, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Jesus Christ, Lamb of God, Lamb of God. You take away our sins, Jesus Christ, Lamb of God, Lamb of God, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
I am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and you who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. The bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. And if you eat of this bread, you shall live forever. You shall live forever, and I will raise you up, and I will
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Andrew, and may our farewell express our affections for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ Jesus, which conquers all things, will destroy death itself. Our brother Andrew has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ, with faith and hope in eternal life. Let us commend him to the loving mercy of our Father and assist him with our prayer. He became God's Son through baptism and was often fed at the table of the Lord. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. And with all the saints, may he inherit the promise of eternal life. Let us now pray to the Lord for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our brother Andrew, and together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life shall appear in glory.
Amen.
Channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. Oh, Master, grant that I may never see so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving to all men that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
I invite you to join with me in the Psalm 116. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living. I love the Lord, for he has heard the cry of my appeal. He returned to his ear to me
in the day when I called him.
They surrounded me, the snares of death, with the anguish of the tomb.
They caught me, sorrow and distress. I called on the Lord's name.
How gracious is the Lord and just. Our God has compassion.
The Lord protects the simple hearts. I was helpless, so he saved me.
Turn back, my soul, to your rest, for the Lord has been good.
He has kept my soul from death and my feet from stumbling.
I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
Praise the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
May the angels take you, Andrew, into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you on your way and lead you to the holy city, Jerusalem. May the choirs of the angels welcome you. And with Lazarus, who was once poor, may you find everlasting rest.
Amen.
Eternal rest give to him, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon him.
May his soul and all the souls of the faithfully departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Alleluia, alleluia, we are going to see the King. Oh, soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Alleluia, soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Alleluia, alleluia, we are going to see the King. There'll be no more crying there. No more crying there. We are going to see the King. There'll be no more crying there. Alleluia, alleluia, we're going to see the King. And very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Alleluia, alleluia, we are going to see the King. Oh, alleluia, oh, alleluia. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Alleluia, soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Alleluia, alleluia, we are going to see the King.
Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the resting places of all who believe in you and made the grave a sign of hope even as it claims our mortal bodies. We ask you, O Lord, that our brother Andrew may rest in this niche in peace until you awaken him to glory. For you are the resurrection and the life, and in he shall see you face to face and know the splendor of God. I bless the niche of Andrew in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We commit, O Lord. We commit, O Lord, our brother Andrew to the deep. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will claim our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. For he is the first fruit of all who have died and believe. And so we ask you, O Lord, to take our brother Andrew to yourself. Softly and tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling for you and for me. See at the portal, he's waiting and watching, watching for you and for me. Come home, come home, ye who are weary, come home. Earnestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling, oh sinner, come home. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the life of our brother Andrew, who was bonded to your people on earth by his love. We pray that he may be bound to the angels in heaven through your mercy. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved the wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind. But now I see, 'twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. Almighty God, you know the anguish of the sorrowful, and you are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear those who cry out to you in their need, and console all the family and friends of Andrew, who come to you commending him into your hands. Bless them with the presence of your Holy Spirit, and grant them trust and hope as they continue to believe in your Son, Jesus Christ, in whose name we offer this prayer. Amen.
Amen.
May the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds steadfast on him. And may the Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a shore on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. Oh, I'll fly away. Oh, glory. I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a place where joy will never end. I'll fly away. Oh, I'll fly away, oh glory, I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. Oh, I'll fly away, oh.